The need for the project was due to the amount of crashes or incidents that happened at the intersection over the last 10-year period, including serious injury and fatal crash.
In December of 2020, there was a 21-year-old girl from Gambier that passed away in the crash. It just devastated the community, you know. I mean, there were hundreds of people that came to this girl's funeral. And a number of folks who have been on emergency rescue had said that this was just one too many.
The district had tried some intermediate or low-cost measures. The crashes continued to occur. We wanted a more longer-term fix to the issues we were seeing. So we worked with the local community to implement a single-lane modern roundabout to address those crash patterns.
The roundabout method was chosen for the pure safety aspects, that it would be significantly better than traffic signal. In the long run, when you think about a traffic signal, it's a little bit more maintenance heavy over the years compared to a roundabout. And it serves the number one purpose, which is improving the safety for this area.
They jumped on it, looked at a few options as far as what we could do in the roundabout, but it really was very restrictive. So we got through the feasibility study pretty quick and then started into design and coordinating so we could get to construction as quickly as possible.
The roundabout choice was a little difficult for this particular intersection due to the topographical nature of the intersection and the elevation disparities between the elevation of the bridge and State Route 308. Because of that, we increased the slope around the roundabout to get from one side to the other, but that locked us into one position for the roundabout. We were in a FEMA flood zone because of the Cocosing River. As we widened the roundabout coming off of the bridge for the entry and exit legs, there was a little bit of fill inside of that FEMA flood zone. So therefore we had to do a little bit of cut further on the west leg to provide compensatory storage area so that those volumes wouldn't have changed over time.
The maintenance of traffic, we really didn't have a lot of options. There, with all the other aspects that we had to mitigate, there was only one option, that was a complete closure. We understand when we do a complete closure, it's going to have kind of a rippling effect throughout the community. So we worked with Kenyon on start of college, end of college time with move-in, tried to avoid some of those times. Worked with the local community on what their preferred detour routes are.
The village had a specific lighting requirement that they wanted us to incorporate into the design. They wanted dark sky compliant lighting, which reduces the amount of light that goes upward and keeps it downward to effectively eliminate or reduce the light pollution for the area.
This is the first roundabout in Knox County, so there's been a few growing pains there, but overall we've been pleased with the safety performance of the roundabout.
When we had the ribbon cutting, so many residents in the community came up to me, including those of the family members of the girl who was killed, to say, we're so glad that, you know, this was done and the way it was done, and that we should never have another crash here, or if there is a crash, we may call a tow truck, but never an ambulance.
I thought the project was fantastic all the way through, from planning to design to finish construction. I'm very proud of the project. I'm very proud of our team.
We all worked really well together. Safety was the number one aspect, and I think it really turned out very well because of that.
If we look at what it took to get to where we are today, the collaboration between ODOT and 2LMN and Verdantis and the Rural Transportation Planning Organization, Corpo, it was amazing.
It looks fantastic. I know it's in its infancy, so we'll have to see what the traffic numbers say in the upcoming years, but hopefully it's significantly less crashes or zero, and the severity of the crashes will be reduced significantly as well.